This is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today I have another exciting episode for you, and we're here in suburbia once again. I mean, I know that's where many of you guys live, and this is the episode you want to be watching, especially if you don't have any green thumbs like you think I do, and I really might. But in any case, we're going to show you a way that you can grow some food, even if you don't have green thumbs. You know, the gardener here at this house that's now growing food would not be growing a garden if it wasn't for the specific system that he's using to grow in, because literally it takes virtually no brains to set it up, and they have excellent customer support to get you growing in it even without any prior experience or prior knowledge. I mean, it's a whole self-contained kit that you need to barely buy two things, I think, at a local hardware store, Lowe's, or Home Depot. But the whole kit is self-contained, comes in a box with everything you need, including the seeds, so that you can start growing. I mean, in today's atmosphere, you know, everybody's concerned about what they're eating. Even organic foods, you could spray certain things on it and it could still be called organic. You know, whether that's good or bad, you know, you just don't know what they're spraying. But when you grow your own food yourself, you have control, you have more power, and you have more freedom to choose what you're gonna eat, and especially what you're gonna grow. There's so many different varieties of, you know, vegetables, fruits, and herbs that are just not sold in the grocery store, but you could definitely grow at home. So what we're gonna do now is actually go into the backyard here and show you this specific garden that allows pretty much anybody without any experience to start growing. Now we're gonna head to the side yard, which is where they're growing their food. But before we do, I wanna stop for a second and talk about the soil here in South Florida. You know, here in South Florida, I mean, this is the beach. It's like, this is literally sand. I mean, I would not grow anything in this stuff. And that's probably the reason why they haven't gardened here before, because, you know, many places in the country may have poor soils, whether it's sand or whether it's clay. It's just not conducive for growing. While you may be able to grow palm trees and some shrubs and whatnot, you know, vegetable gardening in the sand is not a good thing. So the reason why I like what they're using here is because, you know, they take all the guesswork out. They include the soil media you will use to grow your plants in. So next, let's take a look at the garden that they're using today. So now we're gonna head into the backyard, and you know, we're just in the standard side yard here. And in the side yard, they have maybe like 2 feet of space to use before they get to the fence and the neighbor's house. Normally, this is not a lot of real estate to grow anything. You might be able to trellis like some, you know, squash vines or cucumbers up, or maybe grow a trellis with some tomatoes or some chaote squash or something that vines up, and be some sweet potatoes. But normally this space is not able to be used in a large way to grow any volume of food. So most people just, you know, don't use the space in the side of the yard, so they tend to grow in the backyard. But one of the reasons why I like the system here that we're gonna go back and check out, it's right through there, is because this really makes the best use of the space to grow vertically. Now what we're looking at here is a mighty fine backyard farm that's a vertical farm, and it's also a hydroponic farm. So this takes all the guesswork out of what nutrients you're gonna add, because it's all included. And as you can see, it's just really simple. It's just the kit that's available online comes with 5 containers. This is set up with actually 4, and each one holds 4 plants. So it's 4, 8, 12, 16. And I knew I went to grade school for something. And you could add another one would come in the kit, and that would be 20 plants in this. Plus, you get to also add a root box. So the root box is not included in the kit. What they're using here is a standard like styrofoam beer cooler to have your beer in. You know, if that cooler gets old or maybe you stop drinking beer, this is a good use to it, to use it to grow your vegetables. So they're actually growing some kale in here, but normally they would maybe plant some beets, some rutabaga, or even some carrots in here. And how this system works very simply is they have over here, let me go ahead and show you guys that. They have a water storage vessel. And this vessel is simply a garbage can. This is like a big commercial industrial garbage can. I always recommend you guys get a good storage vessel whenever possible. It reminds me of like some Star Trek episode with Chekhov saying something about vessels, I forget. But anyways, you could use this, you could use a 55 gallon drum or whatever big storage container. And all they simply do is they add in water, and then they add in the nutrient solution that's provided in the measuring cup that is also provided, and you have to fill this up. And I talked to the homeowner here, he says he has to fill this up like maybe every 7 to 10 days so he could easily go on a vacation, and nobody has to water his plants, and this is all on a timer. The pump comes on, it automatically waters so that you don't have to. You know, watering your plants is probably one of the biggest reasons why plants don't make it. Either they're overwatered or underwatered. in this system. It's all dialed in so that you do not have to remember to water your plants. Plus, they include the nutrient solution, so you don't have to worry about fertilizing or doing anything, because it's all in a package and it's all done for you. So once you got this set up, the pump in there, got it on the timer, the water just flows through the irrigation pump and then just basically flows down the top into the pots, and then it drains down with the gravity, and then it goes to the root box, and then any additional water just drains out the bottom. And you know, it waters all the plants. So I mean, they have a variety of things growing here in South Florida right now at this time. They got things like the chives, some cilantro, some mint, chocolate mint actually. Mmm, smells really good. I love my chocolate mint. Let me go ahead and try some. It's especially good if you're going on a date and you got bad breath. Chew on some chocolate mint. She'll love you for it. Keep on going down here, and they got the root box. Now another cool thing that's optional, you don't have to do, is that they put a pipe, EMT electrical conduit here between them. Normally they could just put the irrigation tubing, which they supply, and this is a white colored irrigation tubing, so especially here in South Florida where it gets so hot, it's not gonna absorb the heat like the black irrigation pipe would. They got EMT tubing, and they just hanged an additional little planter in between to even better maximize the space, and this is not included in the kit, but you can get these planters anywhere, fill it up with a soil mixture, and you could use that same super nutrition from the water reservoir to feed your own plants in addition to the system that they send you. So it looks like they got some amazing tomatoes here, and check this out. This thing is just loaded up with some little cherry tomatoes here. And let me see if I could vouch for the quality of these tomatoes. Wow, that's super sweet. Now besides just the tomatoes, they're growing a lot of other herbs, and I think herbs are an excellent thing to grow here in South Florida because they're generally more resistant to the weather. They got some sage, some basil, some thyme. You got the money, honey, I got the thyme. And they got some rosemary here. But even in this system, you can grow things like tomatoes and peppers and leafy greens. So at the bottom, of course, I showed the kale earlier, but they also have bell peppers growing. So these are some standard size bells right here. And these plants are growing amazingly in this hydroponic system. Continuing on down over here, check out this one plant, man. This thing is loaded up. I mean, this is crazy. One plant, holy moly peppers, all these long, huge peppers growing in this system. So I could definitely say by looking at this system, seeing how it's set up, it definitely works. I mean, there's even more peppers on here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Man, like a dozen in this one pepper plant in one spot in this growing system. Imagine if you had each one 20 plants times 10. Man, that's a lot of peppers, especially when they're hot ones. You might be limited in growing in South Florida just because of the sheer weather. The weather gets so hot in the summertime, and normally in the wintertime in South Florida, that's when they grow their tomatoes and peppers and normal crops. In the summertime, a lot of gardeners just give up growing because they think it's too hot, but they have another solution that they've been experimenting with, and I like that. So let's go back to another part of the yard and show you what they're using. So this is one of the ways they're attempting to combat the sun, and this is just experimental. There have been some studies done at different universities regarding this stuff. And what this stuff is actually called, it's called aluminet. You might be familiar with like the black shade cloth. Now black shade cloth comes in like different percentages. Might let 50% of the light through, 70% of the light through, or 30% of the light through. This aluminet also will let a percentage of the light through as well. So this one here, I believe, lets through about 50% of the light. But more importantly, because this is an aluminum fabric, it actually reflects the heat. And the heat is actually, in my opinion, what's probably more detrimental to the plants than the actual light. Because in high heat situations, for example, the tomatoes aren't going to flower and set fruit. So pretty much you're at a standstill until the temperatures drop down. So that's why they're covering this garden with the aluminet to see how it's going to work in the hot summer months coming up real soon. And we're just going to go ahead and try to throw this up so you guys can see a little bit of it. And here's the garden. In this garden, they're growing actually a lot of the leafy greens. Now, you know, I want you to be aware that the leafy greens are one of the most important food crops you can grow. I mean, my channel is called Growing Your Greens because I want you guys to grow your greens and eat them. What many people don't realize is that greens and leafy vegetables are probably one of the highest sprayed food crops, you know, with pesticides. I mean, look at it, even down here in South Florida, growing under natural situations, you know, they're getting bugs. But holes in your leaves are a good thing because these are not sprayed with toxins. I'd rather have holes in my leaves and eat it than this sprayed with toxins that could actually be harmful to myself, and if I was a lady, to my unborn baby. One of the cool things is, you know, the greens also are high in folate or folic acid, which, you know, and I think I have read that some people that are pregnant may be deficient in. So by eating more greens, you could, you know, avoid taking a supplement, and by growing your own greens, you could also avoid those pesticides in the foods. But it looks here like they're doing really good. They got some spinach growing really nice. This whole thing is pretty much all leafy greens. They got even things like zucchinis. Man, check out this zucchini down here growing. You can see here, I mean, this is growing really good. There's nothing better than a nice large zucchini to spiralize up for your dinner. I mean, they're just growing all kinds of different things. It is getting a little bit hot even in here, and this is near the end of the season for the lettuce, but the lettuce has been picked back a lot. And you know, I don't have to tell you guys, for those of you guys that have been growing, that you know, the food that you grow in your backyard tastes far better than anything money can buy, especially here in South Florida, where they gotta, you know, harvest the produce in California, they hydrocool, they put it on a truck, they ship it out here, and then you finally get it out here. It's like 7 days old. I mean, how would you like the house homeowner here said, you know, his daughter came out and picked salad and brought it right in and they ate it for dinner. I mean, that's amazing. And you know, the reason why I like this hydroponic vertical garden system is because it allows you to do that with virtually, you know, no knowledge of how to grow. I mean, that's the homeowner here. This is what he actually did with this system, and it allows him to eat fresh leafy greens and other crops out of his garden each and every night. I guess the last thing I want to do is actually I want to show you guys actually what they fill this with. They're resetting right now for the new growing season. So they've taken out some of the plants, and as you can see in here, this is what they fill this with, and this is included. So you don't have to buy anything extra when you get this kit. All you got to do is, you know, you got to get the conduit to stake down through the vertical garden, and you have to get a water container like a garbage can or a rain barrel or a 55-gallon drum to hold the water, but everything else is included, and I like that, including the growing medium, which they're using here. And in this growing medium, all they're gonna simply do is send you some coconut core and some perlite here. You fill up the bottom with the perlite, and then you put a layering on top of the coconut core. Now, the reason why they do this is because the coconut core will absorb in the water and hold the water just like a sponge, and it'll let it down, trickle it down into the perlite in the bottom. And the roots will just grow through the coconut core into the perlite. So in this way, you're gonna get definitely the most water to the newts to aerate the roots, because the perlite's really light and fluffy so that the plants could grow faster. I guess the last thing I wanna talk about is, you know, I said this is a complete kit with everything you need. We're gonna share with you actually the starting kit, the germination kit, because that's one of the biggest challenges that many people have, is like watering their seedlings and making sure they grow properly. Now I wanna go into actually what comes with a kit. I talked about, you know, some of the things that you will have to buy, and one of the reasons why I like actually this vertical hydroponic growing system is because basically it includes everything you need, including the seed wrap right here, the special starting mixture, and the seeds you need. I mean, and even the little aluminum pan here that you're gonna float your seed wrapped in. So I mean, they've really well thought out and designed this system so that you can have the utmost level of success. I mean, another thing that I really like about this system is that they give you full and complete instructions, plus instructional videos that go step by step. And if that's not enough, you could call them anytime for support, and they'll even walk you through how to set one of these up and how to get it going, because they will hold your hand. I mean, that's what they're doing. And I mean, I think that's how every company should operate. I mean, a lot of companies, you'll call the 800 number, press 1 for this, 5 for that, 6 for that, and you'll never get to talk to anybody, and they'll take a voicemail. This company, you call them, and probably most of the time during business hours, they'll actually answer you and definitely take care of you. So here's the little seed wrap. It's very easy to use. You're just gonna take the seed starting mixture, put it in here, and then you're gonna just take a little pencil and dibble a little hole, put the seed in there, and put a little bit of media on top, and then just fill this up with water and let it float. I mean, this is the very system that professional farmers use to start hundreds of plants each season. Finally, once your plants do come up, you're then gonna just go ahead and take the bottom of this here, and they have these little holes here, and you're gonna take a standard like number 2 pencil like you had to use in school to fill out that Scantron, if you remember what that is. I don't think they got those anymore. And then take the eraser and then just pop it through this little hole, and the little plug is gonna pop out, and then that's what is gonna go in to your mighty fine vertical backyard farm. I mean, this is a complete design system. I mean, I've had other episodes where I show systems like this and they just sell the pots, or they just sell this, they just sell that. This is one integrated system that makes it easy for anyone without any prior gardening knowledge that they can grow. Just like the homeowner here, he had no prior growing knowledge, and if it wasn't for the system that made it so easy, he actually probably wouldn't be growing his food today. So that's the real power of this system. If you're a master hydroponic grower, this is probably not the system for you. You could probably piece together your stuff. But if you're one of those people that are concerned about the quality of the food they're eating, especially the leafy greens, you know, you don't want to pay the high prices at Whole Foods anymore. You're sick of that. You don't want to buy conventional produce that's been sprayed, and even organic produce, you know, is it really organic? Who knows? I think this provides a valuable solution for those, you know, who can use it. The last thing I want to say today is that I've negotiated a special discount for Growing Your Greens viewers. If you go to their website, mightyfinegardens.com, and you put in the discount code GYG, that'll get you an additional discount off your purchase. And in that way, you'll be able to grow affordably and get some handholding if you need it. I really love my time here in South Florida. Actually, I'm pretty much almost late to catch my flight. I gotta fly back tonight, but by the time you see this, I'll be back filming some more episodes for you guys to show you guys even more ways you can start growing some food at home, because that's my whole mission to you guys, is I want every family in America to start growing. And once again, this system will allow those people that have never grown before to start doing it, basically because of the customer support that's provided. So once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time, and remember, keep on growing.